ladies and gentlemen, the next match is a 160-pound purple belt Noki match. Introducing first, from 313 Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, please welcome Zach Maybe.
Yo.
Boy, we are with green, this for my crew.
And his opponent, now making his way to the mat, representing Black Tie Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, please welcome Christopher Carpenter.
No friends in the industry, my brothers been my brothers, man. You niggas ain't no kin to me, a fact. Yeah, you heard about me, y'all know me more than that. Yeah, I know I, hey, yeah. No friends in the industry, my brothers been my brothers, man. You niggas ain't no kin to me, a fact.
Oh, we bust out. Yeah, another one of your guys up in here? Chase, my goodness.
Chris coming out aggressive right away. Zach pulling guard. This has been an explosive start to the match.
Very explosive. Double ankle sweep. Tell us a little bit about your guy, Chase.
He's very dedicated student. He's in pretty much every day. Like we just saw, he has a judo background. He actually teaches the kids at our school.
I just saw that Hiraigoshi right there, that was beautiful.
I've been on the receiving end of a couple of those, and they do not feel good.
I can tell that he has that good pinning down, too. I tell you what, I was looking at you, and I just looked, oh, man, okay.
Already looking to finish.
It was right on cue when you said judo background, right to the right.
Chris taking the mount position. Looking to get a head wrap, pin the hands, but Zach gets out. Now playing a half guard type position.
Well, obviously, as a judo guy, I know his top game is probably a lot of pressure. He probably is more pressured in terms of his size.
Yes.
I would imagine.
Yeah, a lot of sitting out onto the chest, really driving that weight, trying to crush their diaphragm. Front headlock here for Chris.
Uh-oh.
Possibly looking for a mounted guillotine.
I see Brett over there. Hey, you guys represented pretty well, too. I was talking about 313. You guys got a lot of guys in this. Uh-oh.
Chris in on the guillotine.
High elbow guillotine.
He's got the leg hooked.
Hey, that's tight.
This looks tight. Now mounted. If he can drop his hips, this might be over.
Just readjust it.
Zach doing a good job.
Oh, that's there.
That's tight, though.
That's very tight.
That is very tight.
When you see guys start rolling and scrambling, he readjusts it.
And he's out. Very good defense. Oh, back on another one.
Chase, you and I talked, and I think a lot of guys are losing the pressure once on the readjustment. I'm sure that's something you guys are going to go back to the academy and work.
Absolutely, yeah. We're going to work on keeping that, not readjusting, really keeping that constant pressure to drive through, which is where you'll see the finishes.
So we see Zach maybe up top now.
Now Zach, oh, Chris turning back on top though. Chris now
looks
passed.
Looks like he has good passing.
Yeah, very good passing display. Settling in a mount.
Looks like he's trying to set up a no-arm Ezekiel here, possibly.
Potentially. Postured back up. It looks like he's trying to hand fight and set something up that way. Potential back take here. Zach able to use it to turn back on top. Yeah.
Judo guys are a lot like wrestlers in the fact of, I know if they're in, because I have a few at my academy. I have a lot of wrestlers. One of the hardest parts is to get them to understand that bottom. Their top is good, but he looks like he's the total package here, just watching.
Yes, he's not just a judo guy. Oh. Many years. See right here, setting up that arm bar from bottom, and that's
the Juji Gatami. Judo terms. Wow. The guy, Chris, put on a nice display of jiu-jitsu. Let me go talk to him, Chase.
Chris, I see your coaches, Jesse and Chase. They are very proud of you. You want to talk about that finish?
Honestly, I just want to give two shout-outs. One to my mom and my girlfriend for supporting me. One to my youth students. You can do anything you want. Enough practice, hard work, dedication. The finish was an armbar. I kind of fell into it. It wasn't my game A, but I saw it, and I applied, tell her to tap.
Well, Chase let me in on a little secret. He tells me you're a judo guy, so I'm not surprised at that arm bar. Beautiful throw, I believe, Hirayagoshi, possibly.
I don't remember. I'm going to be honest. I remember going in there trying to stay calm and not expecting to be as tired as I am. It's that adrenaline dump, man. These lights, this stage, it's incredible. Huge honor to come out here and compete. Thank you all to everyone.
Hey, everybody, give it up for Chris from Black Tie Jiu-Jitsu. Guys, we're going to be back with more. Don't forget our main event. We have Matthias Denise versus David Garmo coming up soon.